In today's video, I'm going to show you how you can take the color grade from any Hollywood film and apply it to your own footage in Premiere Pro. Let's get into it. So here in my timeline, I have this tractor at work. It's a stock video clip that I got from Envato Elements, and I want to copy the color grade from Mad Max Fury Road. So I've imported a JPEG still from the film in my timeline, and you can download stills from movies from a site called ShotDeck. I recommend them. You can just search and download any still that you want, and you can get a 2-week trial. It's pretty great. So once you have it imported in your timeline, how do we copy this color to the stock video clip? This is where we go and use Lumetri color panel. So once you have it open, you're going to go to color wheels and match. Make sure that you have your clip selected, not the JPEG still. Then select comparison view, and this will bring up a side-by-side. On the left is the reference shot. This is our photo, the still from the film that we want to copy the color from. And on the right, this is our current playhead. So this will show wherever your current playhead is, and this is correct. We want it on the stock video clip that I have. So what we're gonna do now is select apply match. Now you can see it made some changes. It's not perfect. There's a few more things that I'm gonna show you how to do, but you can see it just brought up the mid-tones to the orange and the reds and a little bit of red in the highlights, and it lowered the highlights down a bit. So from here, we need to add a little bit more teal in the sky, some more contrast and some saturation, which I will show you how to do in a moment. But first, my name is Kelsey and welcome back to Gal. If this video is helping you out so far, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe if you want some more video editing tips and visual effects tips that I post here on the channel. And by the way, as I mentioned before, that tractor shot is from Envato Elements, and I love Elements so much. I partnered up with them, and you can get 70% off your first month. What exactly is Elements? It's basically a subscription marketplace where you can download unlimited assets from stock video to Photoshop templates to Premiere Pro templates, sound effects, music. It literally has everything. And I swear, it's helped me so much if I just need a random stock video clip or a cool effect of just confetti bursting up. So I'll put a link down below if you want to check them out. But thanks so much to Elements for partnering with me. Oh, one more thing. I put together a Hollywood movie LUT preset pack, which is available on my store, premieregal.com/store. You can go there to purchase the pack, and you can just drag and drop these presets I made on top of your footage, and I'll tell you more about that at the end. Now let's get back into the video. So now we need to change the color of the sky. You could use the curves for that, but I actually had better results using the HSL secondary. So open that up, and from here we can set the color. So we want to isolate the blue color, so you can use these dropper tools to select the color. So initially we can use the first dropper tool to select the color. Then you can see our selection by turning on the mask, and then you can use the plus or the minus to add in more color. So I can add in some more of the blue here just by selecting it, and use the subtraction tool if I need to. So I'm just going to quickly go through and select the sky using these dropper tools. So I think this selection is good enough. I just wanted to basically isolate the top part of the sky to make it more of a teal color. So now we can uncheck the mask, and now we can go to correction and bring this target down to a more teal color until it matches. So I think right around here is just right. And from here, we can add a little bit of saturation. And this would just add saturation just to this color, by the way. It's not adding saturation anywhere else. And this is why it's great to use HSL secondary if you want to bring out some vibrancy in just one of the colors. So just a slight amount of saturation is fine. Yeah, I think this is looking pretty good. One more thing that we can do is we can go up to basic correction, and we can go and add in some contrast, maybe around 35, and a little bit of saturation overall. This is the before and the after. So you can really have fun with these controls to really paint your new color graded image from that still. Of course, it's not going to be exactly perfect because, you know, it might be a different camera, a different lens, but you can get pretty close using these controls. If you're looking for some quick presets, I've designed 20 Hollywood looks. I created a pack on my store, the Hollywood Movie Color Preset LUT Pack. You can see all of the films that I created presets for, both LUTs and Premiere Pro presets. So the LUTs you can also use with different software, not just Premiere Pro, Final Cut Pro X and DaVinci Resolve, for example. And the presets are great because you can display them in your effects panel just like this. You can see some previews here on my site. Back in Premiere Pro, let's say you want to import the presets first. Instead of using a LUT, you can go over here, control click, import presets, and then you can go into the pack that you downloaded, go to presets, and you can import one of these presets that you want. So I've already imported the presets. If you expand this out, you can see all of them here. So for example, this Joker shot here, let's get out of comparison view. If we want to apply the Joker, you can just double click and apply the Joker. And this was the before and the after. I also have this other shot that looks really good with Matrix from Elements. If I double click to apply the Matrix preset that I designed, it looks very much in the Matrix mode. I also have the Grand Budapest Hotel. If we just double click on that, the before and the after, it just looks a lot more pink and washed out, which was kind of the vibe of the hotel. And the reason why I like them as presets is you can visually see what they look like as a thumbnail from the effects panel. So if you want to use the LUTs instead, you can go up to Lumetri Color and you can go to Creative and you can actually browse. So from here, we can select the Grand Budapest Hotel.cube, which is a LUT file. So now this is the LUT applied. And some people prefer using LUTs and some people prefer using the presets and effects, but both options are there. And one more thing I wanted to mention is if you're using log footage, I first recommend applying a log conversion LUT to Rec 709 and then applying my LUT at the Creative tab. So if you're looking for conversion LUTs, I have some free LUTs down below that converts like Sony log or Canon log into Rec 709. And then you can apply my presets on top of that to create the grade. So that's how you can apply Hollywood-inspired color grades to your own footage. If you have any questions, be sure to leave a comment just down below. And if you want to learn more about color grading or just video editing in general, you can watch the playlist right over here. And to subscribe, you can click right over here on my profile to stay notified when I publish new videos. That's all for today's video. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.